The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Happy morning, students. We have completed two chapters in organic, that is haloalkanes, haloarenes, alcohols, phenols and ethers. See, already we have been tied up with a lot of practical work and we have record work. We have to study the topics which have been taken right now. I want my children not to strain yourself, because almost we have come to the end of this academic year. And we know 12th standard being the most important in your school life. The marks that you have earned in your 11th standard may or may not be fair enough to get you a good percentage. It doesn't mean that everybody, those who get above 90 plus, are good. I want my children, whatever is your capacity, try to do well. Accept that we have to work hard for the following days, because nothing is impossible. If you think you can do it, you can do it. The only thing is you need to take the first step in preparing for your board exam. The dates have come. Now you have 2 months time in front of you. Plan yourself, frame yourself a timetable. Do not miss the classes. Be on with the syllabus and try to work out the previous year's questions at least, because the format is only entirely different. So let us work together. Do not get afraid. Do not get panic. We are here to help you together. Okay, so let us do it together, children. We are getting into the next chapter, that is aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acid. When we are studying about aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acid, we should remember that these are called as carbonyl compounds. Why they are called as carbonyl compounds is just because the carbonyl group is bonded to a carbon and hydrogen in aldehyde. You have a CO group which is present in almost aldehyde, ketones, carboxylic acid, ester and acetic anhydride. So we will see, if the carbonyl group is just present between the carbon and hydrogen, you call it as aldehydes. And if they are present in between two carbon atoms, we call them as ketones. And carboxylic acid, definitely we have another hydroxyl group which is attached to the carbon atom apart from our oxygen. So this is the general thing that we need to learn about aldehydes, ketones and acids. So today we will see about aldehydes and ketones. Now this is the structure of an aldehyde, RCHO, where R is our alkyl group. When we have ketone, I told you it is CO between two carbon atoms, so you have two alkyl groups and this is my acid. Now when I say esters, anhydrides, everything, now these are the derivatives that you get from your carboxylic acids. So naming of these compounds you can just go through, children, which we have already learned how to use alone for ketone, oic acid for acid. So now we will get into our structure. Now if you watch the structure, the CO bond, if you see it, the carbonyl carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. The type of hybridization is sp2 and it forms 3 sigma bond. You can see there is a sigma bond here, there is a sigma bond, sigma bond. But what happens, the fourth valence electron remains in its p orbital and it forms a pi bond with the carbon and oxygen. So you can see carbon and oxygen forming a pi bond and the bond angle is 120 degree. Now this carbon oxygen double bond is polarized. We know how this polarization takes place. When we have two atoms, and if one atom is more electronegative than the other, the more electronegative atom can pull the electrons pair towards itself. So that will give rise to a polarity, that is a polarization takes place. So there'll be a partial positive and negative charges. So that's why carbonyl carbon are called as Lewis acid and the oxygen is called as a Lewis base, because base, you know what it does, it tries to accept, and acid, it tries to donate. Okay, now we will get into the preparation of aldehydes and ketones. These are some of the preparations which we have already seen in alcohols and haloalkanes. So children, when we are studying organic chemistry, you should always remember that the preparation of one compound can be the property of another compound. So the same reaction may be repeated again and again. So I want you all to remember when those reactions are repeated. Okay, now when we say oxidation of alcohols, so in oxidation of alcohols, which is the preparation of aldehyde and ketone, was the property of alcohol, if you remember children. See, aldehydes and ketones are prepared by oxidation of primary and secondary alcohols. We have already learned that primary alcohols will be oxidized to form aldehydes and secondary alcohol will be oxidized to form ketones. That is what we studied in our alcohol chapter. Now when you come to dehydrogenation, you remember copper at 573 Kelvin, primary alcohol will give an aldehyde, secondary will give a ketone, and tertiary will give an alkene. So here the same thing is used. When alcohol vapors are passed over copper at 573 Kelvin, you get your corresponding aldehydes and ketones. The next one is, we have learnt in plus one science, hydrocarbons. You remember ozonolysis of alkenes, which is giving an aldehyde and ketone. If you remember children, aldehyde CH3CHO plus O3 giving a ozonide structure which splits into two aldehydes. So that is what is ozonolysis. See, definitely I'll be giving you the important reactions written in a paper and I shall send it to you across through your WhatsApp broadcast. Okay. Next is hydration of alkenes. What do you mean by hydration? Addition of water. So here, addition of water to ethyne in the presence of H2SO4 and HgSO4. So in presence of sulfuric acid and mercuric sulfate, what you get is an acetaldehyde. Next one is preparation of aldehydes alone. The first four preparations were preparations of both aldehydes and ketones, but now we are going to learn only preparation of aldehydes. First one, now we have started to learn about the name reactions, which you should always remember. You should write the name of the reaction and then you should write the reaction and learn. First one is Rosenmund reaction. In Rosenmund reaction, what happens? Any acid chloride, when it is treated with hydrogen in presence of palladium as catalyst and barium sulfate, you get an aldehyde. So benzoyl chloride, COCl, is an acid chloride. So benzoyl chloride, when treated with hydrogen at palladium and barium sulfate, will give benzaldehyde. So this reaction we call it as Rosenmund reaction. The next one is Stefan reaction. In Stefan reaction, what happens? Nitriles are reduced. We are going to do reduction. What is a nitrile? RCN is my nitrile group, CN, right? So nitriles, when they are treated with stannous chloride, SnCl2, in presence of mineral acid HCl, you get RCH double bond NH. This is called as an imide, which is an intermediate, which on hydrolysis will give an aldehyde. So such reactions we call it as Stefan reaction. So in Stefan reaction, nitriles will be reduced to aldehydes. Now listen to this, this is a one mark question. Nitriles are selectively reduced by dibal H. This is a one mark question. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Diisobutyl, AL is for aluminium hydride, will be reduced to imines, which is on further hydrolysis will give an aldehyde. Such reactions we call it as Stefan reaction. You can see the first step, how it is happening, and you are getting your RCHO. Another example is also given. Now similarly, you can reduce esters also. Esters can also be reduced to aldehydes using your dibal hedge. So this is my ester. You can write any example, children, you need not write the same example. Any ester on treatment with the same reagent will give my aldehyde. You just have to remember the concept of the number of carbon atoms. Here what is changed here is, you can see CH3CH29 remains the same. This part get reduced to CHO. So same thing you should write with any other ester, okay. Next is from hydrocarbons. First one is oxidation of methyl benzene. Strong oxidizing agents can reduce its derivatives by getting, what do you mean by oxidation? That is, the normal compound is getting added with oxygen. So here you have different oxidizing agent. First one is chromyl chloride. What is chromyl chloride? CrO2Cl2. What is happening here? If you see, observe the reaction. Toluene, you can see toluene C6H5CH3, which on treatment with chromyl chloride in presence of CS2, which is carbon disulfide as a solvent, you get a chromium complex. You have to remember this chromium complex. CH2 is removed, so you have here CHOCrOHCl2. Same thing, H comes inside here, right? Now which on hydrolysis will be giving my aldehyde? This name reaction is called as an Itard reaction. It is called as Itard reaction. Next one is using chromic oxide. First one was with chromyl chloride. Next one was chromic acid. Same toluene when it is treated with chromic acid, but here you are going to use your acid anhydride. Which is acid anhydride? It is CH3CO2O. This is my acid anhydride. So this, when treated with acid anhydride, CH will be here, OCOCH3 comes, OCOCH3 comes, which is twice. So two times it comes here. One of the hydrogen comes out, which on hydrolysis and heating will give my benzaldehyde. So both the reactions are same, only the oxidizing agents are different. Next one is a side chain chlorination. What do you mean by side chain? The side part get chlorinated, which will be further hydrolyzed. That is, toluene, when it is treated with chlorine in presence of sunlight, you get your benzyl chloride. That is, CHCl2 comes, HCl will be removed, which on hydrolysis will give my benzaldehyde. So there are 3-4 reactions how benzaldehyde can be prepared. Rosenman reaction, Itard reaction, two methods are there, and you have this side chain hydrolysis. The next one is Gaterman-Koch reaction. One more name reaction. In Gaterman-Koch reaction, if you see, benzene will be treated with carbon monoxide in presence of HCl. We have a catalyst here, anhydrous aluminium chloride, which will be on oxidation gives benzaldehyde. So this is called as Gaterman-Koch reaction. Okay, it's again a name reaction. So till now we were seeing the preparation of aldehyde. Now let us get into the preparation of ketones. First one was with Grignard reagent. If you can remember, children, Grignard reagent, acyl chloride. See, this is very, very important reaction where there's a two-step involved. RMGX is my Grignard reagent, which when treatment with cadmium chloride, you get R2CD. This CD comes and joins with my alkyl group, MgXNCl comes out. Okay, now we don't want this. Now I'm going to use my R2CD. What is R2CD called as? This is called as, see here, dialkyl cadmium. Two alkyl groups with cadmium, so it is dialkyl cadmium, which when treated with an acid chloride, you get a ketone plus cadmium chloride. So this is very, very important reaction, a two-step reaction, which you should learn it by heart. Next is from nitriles. Just now we saw nitrile-Stefan reaction, you remember? It's the same nitriles. When it is treated with Grignard reagent, let's see what happens. Okay, now see here, Nitrile, CN, when it is treated with a Grignard reagent in presence of ether as a solvent, you get here CH3CH will be present here. There will be one dash in that. This C will be splitted into two, where in one side you have N with MgBr getting connected, and the other side this will be split. C6H5MgBr will be split into two parts, where in C double bond N you have this MgBr, and in single bond you have this phenyl group, which on hydrolysis this complete part gets oxidized to double bond O. That is how you get your ketone. And the next reaction is Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, where benzene, when it is treated with acid chloride in presence of a catalyst like aluminium chloride, which we have learned from 11th standard, you get your acetophenone. That is OC double bond O. It can be my CH3 or it can be my benzene phenyl ring also. So this reaction is called as acylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. What is acylation? This acyl group, COR group, comes and gets connected with my benzene ring. So that we call it as acylation. Okay, I hope you are able to follow whatever we have studied till now. In physical properties, you have the boiling points of aldehydes and ketones, which is comparatively higher than the corresponding hydrocarbons because of their increase in their molecular masses. And also with dipole-dipole interaction because of difference in their electronegativity. But what is happening with the solubility? The solubility of aldehydes and ketones actually decrease on increasing the length of alkyl chain. When the alkyl chain actually increases, the solubility actually decreases. So all aldehydes and ketones are soluble only in the organic solvent, and they are not soluble in water to a greater extent. Okay, next one is chemical reactions. See, this is very important because this question, this part will be asked in the exam frequently in the like give reason questions. Okay, aldehydes and ketones, if you see, they undergo nucleophilic addition reaction. What is nucleophilic addition? A nucleophile, we know what is a nucleophile, which is rich in electrons, which will come and attack the substrate. So if you see here, a nucleophile attacks the electrophilic carbon. Why it is called as electrophilic carbon? Because it is electron deficient of the polar carbonyl group. Carbonyl group is CO, oxygen being more electronegative will have delta negative charge, carbon will bear delta positive charge. Because of that, carbon which is having a positive charge will be attacked by the nucleophile. So such an attack will be on the plain polarized sp2 carbon. So now you can see the structure here. This carbon which is delta positive, when the nucleophile comes and attacks, what is happening? This double bond actually shift. So when the double bond shifts, it goes and attacks the oxygen. So oxygen will start bearing a negative charge, which on hydrolysis will give a OH. So we have a nucleophile which is attached here, and this is also OH. Such a reaction which called as nucleophilic addition. Attack of the nucleophile at the carbon center, movement of the double bond towards the oxygen, and then on further hydrolysis or addition reaction, you get the addition product. Now, the most important part, aldehydes are generally more reactive than ketones in nucleophilic addition reaction. Now, whenever nucleophilic addition reactions are happening, this is a frequently asked question. Why aldehydes are more reactive than ketones? If you see, children, in aldehyde, it is CH3CHO. That is, one side you have an alkyl group, a bulky group, carbon with one side hydrogen and double bond oxygen. But if you see a ketone, the CO bond is between two alkyl groups. So we have two bulky groups which are present in ketone. So the presence of two relatively large substituents in ketones, it hinders the approach of the nucleophile. So when a nucleophile comes and attacks, if this is my CH3 and this is my hydrogen, hydrogen is little bit lesser, not that bulkier, so the nucleophile can easily attack. But in the same case, if I have both methyl group or ethyl group or any other bulky group as my substituents, the nucleophile will find less difficult, or these groups may hinder, it may obstruct the attack of my nucleophile. So that's why we say aldehydes are more reactive towards nucleophilic addition as compared to that of my ketones. This is a repeated question, children, so don't forget it. Okay. Now we'll see some of the important reaction, nucleophilic addition reactions. How does it happen? Every addition reaction has the same method. Only thing is the reagent are different. First one is addition of hydrogen cyanide. So HCN, in presence of a nucleophile, first we need to generate a new nucleophile. So what happens? You get CN, removal of water takes place. Now this CN is my nucleophile, which is going to attack my aldehyde. So I have an aldehyde which is having delta plus and delta minus. This nucleophile comes and attacks my carbon. So there is a movement of the double bond towards the oxygen. So I get a structure like this. Carbon, both bonds here, one side CN is attacked, one side O is attacked. So this will be my intermediate, which on hydrolysis will give CN and H comes and attack. So this is called as cyanohydrin. Very simple reaction for you to understand. Same, instead of the CN, we have another nucleophile, which is sodium bisulfite. So sodium or hydrogen sulfite also you can call. Here OS, that is SO3H, which is OSO2H. This will be split as Na and HSO3. So one side ONa comes and attack, the other side it will be OSO2H. This will be splitted into cation and anion. So there is a proton transfer. Where the transfer is taking place, this hydrogen comes and attacks my oxygen, the sodium goes and joins with my sulfur. So I have SO3Na and I have my OH, which is my bisulfite addition product. Okay, now the hydrogen sulfite addition compound is water soluble and can be converted back to my original compound with dilute mineral acid. So if I want this to be again an aldehyde, I can add it with mineral acid or an alkali. Next one is with Grignard reagent, which we studied again in chapter 11. If you remember, children, the last topic we studied, okay, in addition of Grignard reagent for the formation of alcohol. Next one is addition of alcohols. Now how does this reaction takes place? We have an aldehyde and a ketone group. Aldehyde, when it is, why I have put R dash here is because this can be my CH3, so I should differentiate these two. So this can be my C2HY also. So any alcohol, when it is treated with aldehyde, I have this RCH, there will be a break here, right? One side O will be there, OH will join, this H will join, and the other side OR, again this will be OR dash. So this again splits, this again split. So I get a hemiacetal, which again on treatment with one more alcohol, both will be my OR, that is alkoxy group, which we call it as acetal. This is hemiacetal because we have only half, not both, only half side there is an OR group. Here both will change into OR with the removal of water. So this we call it as acetal. Now what happens with ketone? Similarly, this bond becomes 2. So I have here OCH2. Now this H2O will be removed. We have hydrogen, this OH. Hydrogen from the first and OH from the second will be removed as water. So you have CH2, one oxygen here, one oxygen here. Both oxygen forms a bridge here and you have a ethylene glycol ketal. Because it's a ketone group, so you call it as an ethylene glycol ketal. So these are all addition reactions. Okay, next is using addition of ammonia and its derivatives. When I say ammonia and its derivatives, we have here some of the derivatives of ammonia been given here in the tabular column. Same ketone is taken, NH3, one of the hydrogen can be replaced by an alkyl group, aryl group, it can be OH group, amine, or it can be C6H5NH, so many amide. So when it is replaced by each of these, Z is replaced by these substituents, you have the reagent name, the derivative and how the product will be named. Same is the reaction ketone. You have the bond, double bond getting split into two single bonds, oxygen getting attracted with hydrogen, and you have one hydrogen left in this, which will form NHZ, which again gives double bond NZ, because this hydrogen combines with OH to form H2O, the remaining will be NZ. So this is the using the ammonia and its derivatives. The next one will be again reduction to alcohol. We know aldehydes will be reduced to primary alcohols and ketones will be reduced to secondary alcohols. You can use reducing agents like lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride. Next is with hydrocarbons. Two important reactions which you should learn is Clemmensen's reduction reaction and Wolff-Kishner reaction. In Clemmensen's reduction, if you see, the carbonyl group of aldehydes and ketones is reduced to CH2 by two reagents, zinc amalgam and concentrated hydrochloric acid. So when I use zinc amalgam and HCl, I get here the double bond O broken into H2. CO becomes CH2, the remaining all the same, and you get a removal of water, which is my Clemmensen's reduction. In the second reaction, if you see the double bond using NH2, that is hydrazine. If I use hydrazine NH2, I get double bond NNH2, which when treatment with potassium hydroxide and ethylene glycol as reagent, I get my CH2 directly substituted. So this is a one step reaction. This becomes my two step, where double bond O will be removed and you get NNH2. In this, one hydrogen molecule combines with oxygen to form water. So the remaining will be double bond NNH2, which when treatment with a base and ethylene glycol, I get my hydrocarbon, which is called as my Wolff-Kishner reaction. Okay, so now let us get into, sorry, the page has just moved up. Now we'll just see oxidation reactions of, yes, oxidation. It's fair easy. Oxidation, aldehydes differ from ketones in their oxidation reactions because aldehydes can be directly converted into carboxylic acid using any oxidizing agent like potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate. But ketones are generally oxidized only under vigorous conditions and with strong oxidizing agents at elevated temperature. So they give a mixture of carboxylic acid. You get two different carboxylic acid when you use ketone for oxidation reaction. The next one is, children, actually we used to do these tests in our lab for determination of silver and copper. So we just read what is the test is all about, okay? Because the presence of aldehyde and ketones are this, we do this in finding the organic compounds, whether the given compound is my aldehyde or the given compound is my ketone. You may be having this year, so when you do this practically, it will be easy for you to understand. When you warm an aldehyde with ammoniacal silver nitrate, this is my ammoniacal silver nitrate solution using a base, you get a formation of silver mirror, that is 2Ag. Either you get a black precipitate form or you get a silver mirror at the side of the test tube. So this reaction, you have to learn it by heart, because aldehyde is getting converted to my oxalate ion, that is COO minus, with the precipitation of silver compound metal. Next one is Felling's test, where Felling reagent comprises of two solutions, Felling A and Felling B, right? Now Felling A is aqueous copper sulfate and Felling B is alkaline sodium potassium tartrate, which is called as Rochelle salt. This two solutions, that is, I take my given compound, I add Felling A, then I add Felling B. After some time, what happens? I get a red brown precipitate. If I get a red brown precipitate, that is my ketone, now aldehyde. Now how do we do this? Actually, after adding all this, we keep it in a water bath, that is, on heating an aldehyde with Felling reagent, you keep it in a water bath. After some time, you get a brown precipitate, reddish brown. Same, both the things we will keep it in a water bath. That is, you take a beaker, put the test tube in the water bath, and keep it on the heating unit. So what you get is a silver mirror for tollens and a reddish brown precipitate for fillings. Okay. Next is oxidation of methyl ketones by haloform reaction. I have highlighted here where iodoform reaction with sodium hypoiodide is used for detection of CH3CO group or CH3CHOH group which produces CH3CO. This comes in one mark reaction. To determine CH3CO group, we use this iodoform reaction. This is my methyl ketones, which on treatment with NaOX, you get your CH3CO. This ONa comes and CH3X will be removed. CHX3 is removed. And this, another example is given. They have given another example. They may not ask you to write the reaction, but definitely iodoform reactions are important. Okay. So, this reaction is used for the identification of CH3CO group. Next is we may have to study about aldol reaction, which we call it as alpha hydrogen. What is alpha hydrogen? The carbon in which the oxygen is doubly bonded, that we call it as an alpha hydrogen. Acidity of alpha hydrogen of aldehydes and ketones. The aldehydes and ketones, they undergo a number of reactions due to acidic nature of alpha hydrogen. See, I have my carbon, I have a double bond oxygen which is joined with that. A hydrogen is also attached to the carbon. Now, that alpha hydrogen will be responsible for the acidity of my aldehyde. Acidity of alpha hydrogen atoms of carbonyl compounds is due to strong withdrawing effect of the carbonyl group and the resin structure. See, we have learned right from phenol or benzene, the resonance structure actually increases the acidity. There is a conjugation that is happening, alternate shift of double and single bond. So double bond is here, it becomes single here, again it becomes double here. This is, you may not be asked to draw the structure, but you should just remember acidity is due to the resonance and also the electron withdrawing group. The next one is aldol condensation. This is a bit important reaction. But I don't know this year, since you have lot of choice questions, how this question is going to come. Aldehydes and ketones which have an alpha hydrogen undergo reaction in the presence of dilute alkali as catalyst to form beta hydroxy ketones. So this is my CHO group, this is alpha, this is beta, so beta hydroxy. Okay, and beta hydroxy aldehyde or beta hydroxy ketone. So what is happening here is, this is my ethanol, this is my alpha hydrogen. So this gets split into, there are two aldehyde groups. These two aldehyde groups will split like this. CH3CH will be there. One OH comes here. The other CH3CHO will become CH2CHO. Which on heating, this OH will be removed. One hydrogen from this carbon will be removed and there will be a double bond formed. So this we call it as aldol reaction. You can also see the mechanism in YouTube if you want to see. When you give aldol condensation, they show with animation how the bond actually shifts and how does it form. Okay, children. So such reaction we call it as aldol condensation reaction. What is cross aldol? In aldol condensation, we use the same type of aldehyde, but in cross aldol condensation, we use two different aldehydes. The process is the same, but you get two different products. One you can get double bond here, the other one you get a double bond here. So that such type of reaction we call it as cross aldol condensation reactions. Okay, the last one is Cannizzaro reaction, where aldehydes which are not having alpha hydrogen will undergo self oxidation reaction. The best example is formaldehyde or benzaldehyde. The two formaldehyde combines with concentrated nitric acid to form an alcohol. Here also they forms alcohol and you get a salt which is formed. So these reactions are very important, and you have the name reaction which is called as Cannizzaro. In aldol and cross aldol, the aldehydes are having alpha hydrogen, but here they don't have alpha hydrogens. Again, electrophilic substitution reaction, simple reaction, aldehyde undergoing nitration you get a nitro group at meta position. Remember, there we used to write ortho, meta, para. In aldehyde, in haloalkanes and alcohols, we were focusing only on the ortho and para positions. But here, this is a deactivating group, so it will be a meta directing positions, because these are the carbonyl groups are they destabilize the ring because the electron withdrawing and they focus on the meta position. So don't write in ortho and para position. So children, let us now continue with carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid are the carbon compounds where the functional group COOH is being attached to the carbon chain. Because as we already know, we have studied in 10th standard, when COOH group is being attached to the carbon chain, that carbon will also be considered as a main chain. So if it is connected to an alkyl group, you call it as an aliphatic acid. If it is attached to a ring, benzene ring, you call it as an aromatic acid. Now if you see the structure, now these compounds have got a large number, and where we use the suffix oic acid and ending with E will be replaced by oic acid for a carboxylic group. And when we come about a structure of the carboxylic group in the carbon compound, this is the structure. In carboxylic acid, the bonds to the carboxylic carbon, this is the carboxylic carbon, lie in one plane and is separated is about 120 degrees. You have a 120 degree angle, and the carboxylic carbon is less electrophile than carbon because of the possible resonance structure. What could be the resonance structure? The double bond can shift. It can come to this carbon and oxygen, or it can be with this carbon and oxygen, because we know only the double bond changes to single and single changes to double in a resonance structure. Now let us learn about the preparation of carboxylic acid. The first preparation is from primary alcohols and aldehydes, where it can be done through oxidation. Now they are readily oxidized to carboxylic acid with oxidizing agents like potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate, or this combination we call it as a Jones reagent. It can come in one mark question, which is a combination of sulfuric acid and chromic acid. So here you can see alcohol with alkaline KMnO4 in hydrolysis giving an acid, and here also alcohol with Jones reagent giving an acid. Now these can also be prepared by use of mild oxidizing agents when you use aldehyde as a reactant. So both alcohol and aldehydes can be converted to acids using oxidation. Now from alkyl benzenes, what are alkyl benzene? In a benzene, if an alkyl group is attached, they are called as alkyl benzene. By vigorous oxidation, what do you mean by vigorous? Strong oxidizing agent when you use with chromic acid or acidic alkaline potassium permanganate, and we treated with KOH is nothing but alkali. So this alkali, when it is joined with KMnO4, it is alkaline potassium permanganate. So what happens here? This alkyl benzene, when you get oxidized, it becomes COOK, which on hydrolysis will give my corresponding acid. So children, in place of KOH, if in the question you get NaOH, this becomes COONa, and here again on hydrolysis gives you the corresponding acid. So when you treat with KMnO4, similarly another example is given, the whole carbon chain, that is the aliphatic chain, breaks up and OO gets added. That is, you are doing an oxidation of an alkyl benzene. Next is from nitriles and amides. Nitriles are hydrolyzed. See, nitrile group is RCN and amide is RCONH2. So you should be knowing this. This is nitrile. RCN is nitrile, RNC is isonitrile, these are ambidentous nucleophiles, and R, this is CH3, CONH2 is amide group, that is urea. You know what is the formula for urea? It is CONH2. So this, when hydrolyzed and then to acids in the presence of H plus and OH minus, So RCN, when it is hydrolyzed first, it gets RCO, NH2 and amide, which on further treatment with H plus and OH minus on heating gives my corresponding acid. So amide on hydrolysis will be giving my acid. Benzamide on hydrolysis, benzoic acid. You can just learn the same examples. Instead of CH3 methyl group, if they give ethyl group, you get ethanoic acid. This is ethanamide, ethanoic acid. Propanamide, propanoic acid. So if you see two carbons here, put two carbons. But this NH2 becomes OH. So that is from nitriles and amides. Next is again from Grignard reagent. From Grignard reagent, you have lot of applications and reactions that you are getting. That is RMGX on treatment with carbon dioxide in the presence of dry ether. We know what happens. This bond breaks actually, so you get RCO and here it becomes OMGX. So this CO2, one side it becomes double bond O, the other side oxygen will be attached by MGX and R comes and attacks this electrophile carbon. So what happens here, which on hydrolysis will give RCOOH comes and attacks and then you get MgOHX. So this is how you will prepare your acids from Grignard reagent with carbon dioxide and dry ether as your solvent. From acyl halides and anhydrides, I told you children, esters, acid chloride, acid anhydride, these are the derivatives from acid. So when an acid chloride on is hydrolyzed in presence of H plus and OH minus, you will get your corresponding acid. Example, RCOCl, this can be CH3COCl giving CH3COOH, or it can also break up into an anion and cation, which on further hydrolysis will be giving my corresponding acid. Similarly, anhydride, benzoic anhydride on hydrolysis will give benzoic acid. So very, very easy example. Any anhydride will be giving the corresponding acid on hydrolysis. Next is from esters. Acidic hydrolysis. What is acidic hydrolysis? You do the hydrolysis in acid medium. So gives directly carboxylic acid, while basic hydrolysis will give carboxylate, that is the salt, which on acidification will be giving my acid. So if you see both the reaction, in the first reaction I am doing an acid medium, so I get my acid directly. This is my ester, RCOOR. So this is my aryl group, this is my alkyl group, which on acid hydrolysis giving my acid. This is the same ester on basic hydrolysis is giving the salt, which on hydrolysis will be giving my acid. So that's the two difference between the ester, which on acid hydrolysis and basic hydrolysis. Next, we'll see the chemical reactions. Properties, you can just go through your text. Chemical reactions involves the cleavage of OH bond, where the OH bond actually breaks. That is with metals and alkalis, if you see, we know this on hydrolysis will give an acid. So this when treated with any metal or alkali should give the corresponding salt. So RCOOH plus Na gives RCOONa. With potassium will give the potassium salt. See, this carboxylic acid can easily dissociate in water. What is dissociation? Breaking the bonds and splitting into cations and anions. So while splitting, it becomes a resonance stabilized structure where there is an alternate movement of the double and single bond. If you see this, the equilibrium constant of water and for hydrolysis of acid, if you see, it's a constant. Ka is the acid dissociation and pKa gives log Ka. Log Ka is nothing but we know the pH value. For hydrochloric acid it is 7, and that of fluoroacetic acid they have given, and for benzoic acid 3 different values. So if it is less than 7, we know it is an acid. This is the most important, children. Effect of substituents on the acidity of carboxylic acid. If you have an electron withdrawing group, the electron withdrawing group will pull the electrons from carbon and it stabilizes the carboxylate ion, so the acid becomes more strengthened, that is, it becomes more acidic in nature. But when you put an electron releasing, the donating group, it releases the electrons towards carbon, so it destabilizes this carboxylate ion, thereby it weakens the acid nature of the carbon. So what happens? Electron withdrawing group increases the acidity and electron donating group or releasing group decreases the acid strength. So this can be useful for you. They have given here the directions. So this you can just go through how, what happens when it is being attached. Next is with cleavage of COH bond. We were seeing CO bond. Now this is COH bond, where first, when two acids, similar acids are treated, there is a cleavage of the COH bond. So there is a removal of water taking place and thus it becomes an anhydride. CH3CO, O, CH3CO. That's why we write CH3CO twice O. That is for an acid anhydride. Similarly, for esterification, acid when it's treated with alcohol in presence of an acid, mineral acid, it gives an ester. This we have studied even in 10th standard and 11th standard, esterification process. Next is very easy, formation of acid chloride and formation of amide. Just remember the preparation so you will get the properties. With reactions, what happened? Acid, when it is treated with phosphorus trichloride or pentachloride or thionyl chloride, you get the corresponding acid chlorides. Everywhere it is RCOCl plus the corresponding byproducts POCl3, H3PO3, sulfur dioxide and HCl. So these are the very important reactions for the preparation, or I can say the properties of acid with PCl5. Next is reaction with ammonia. When it is treated with ammonia, definitely we know on heating it will give an amide, because an NH2 group gets added. So OH will be removed here with this hydrogen as water on heating, which will be giving my amide. So benzoic acid will give benzamide, ethanoic acid will give ethanamide. So that is how you will learn the reactions. Phthalic acid, again, with NH3, COO, NH4, ammonium cation, on heating, removal of water takes place. So CONH2, CONH2, which again on strong heating, the bond breaks actually. This becomes COCO. One ammonia is being removed. So you get only NH, which forms a bond here. So you should by heart the reaction in the same way it is written. Next is the whole COOH group is being involved in the reaction, where an acid gets reduced to the primary alcohol. So reduction reducing agents, we know what are the reducing agents we can use. Lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, any reducing agent will be giving my corresponding alcohol. Next one is decarboxylation. We studied about Kolb reaction, where addition of carbon dioxide, here there is a removal. Decarboxylation, the sodium salt of an acid on treatment with NaOH and KaO, we know what is quicklime, it's a dehydrating agent. So this will remove Na2CO3 and you get an alkane, right? So that is how to form hydrocarbons, we use this decarboxylation method. The next one is a simple reactions with hydrocarbon part, where in RCOOH only the R part is reacting here, that is carboxylic acid which is having an alpha hydrogen. This is my COOH, this is my alpha carbon, so this is my alpha hydrogen, will be halogenated with hex2, means chlorine, bromine, any halogen in presence of red phosphorus, giving a substitution reaction. Here one of the hydrogen is being replaced by a halogen, so you get alpha chlorocarboxylic acid or alpha bromo carboxylic acid. So this reaction is called as HVZ reaction, or I can say Helvollard-Zelinski reaction. So you should be learning the name of the reaction, which is important. Now we'll go for ring substitution. This is all substitution where only one of the atom is getting replaced by another one atom or a group of atoms. Benzoic acid, nitration, you get nitrobenzoic acid. If you remember from aldehyde ketones, we are studying only the meta position gets occupied. Ortho and para, they remain the same because we know these are the deactivating groups. So here with bromine and FeBr3 as catalyst, you get bromobenzoic acid, nitrobenzoic acid. Then you have some of the uses been given for carboxylic acid. As of this, the lesson gets over. I have prepared a set of reactions for you with name reactions, which I'll be giving you once you come here, so that you can learn it, which I've given to you in plus one also, which will be helping you to learn more. Okay, children. So with this, our lesson gets over. If you have any doubt, kindly don't hesitate. Once we come here, let us practice those organic reactions. Okay, take care, children. Bye.